died in 1961. I suppose one of the highest compliments ever paid me was paid me by Brother Joseph. He came out on the stoop of the old monastery, they call it Benedict Hall now, and he stood there with his arms folded watching me. I was on a scaffold 50 feet in the air laying stone. And he went back in and he told some of my old college professors here, that man is a craftsman, and I've tried the rest of my life to live up to that. When he died shortly after that in 1961. And in 1963, a tornado came through and knocked a big pine tree down over his model of the Tower of Babel, and it crushed it. And they were really in a dither what they were going to do about it. And Monroe Sears was the assistant to Father Lambert, who was the director of the Grotto at the time. And he told him, call Leo down off of the church, said he can rebuild it. Well, they called me down, and in my spare time after my work at on the church, and then on Saturdays, I rebuilt it. And I started doing the work then. And as I said, one of the next jobs then was to repaint those statues in the Bethlehem scene. I've done the work ever since because they really didn't do anything to the Grotto for several years after Brother Joseph died. No one else could do it, they thought. So they found out that I had done some concrete model work, and I built a little stone model of the Sacred Heart School in town back 2 years before the building was built, and they used it for a fundraising thing, showed it to people. I built it from an architect's picture. I got the, the pointed stones to make it look like the picture. I wasn't here when the abbot came down to look at it after I built it, but they said he stood here on the walk and said, amazing, amazing, and up the walk he went. But he never did say anything to me. I guess at one time maybe he paid me a compliment. After I started doing the work, he said, well, the Grotto's indeed fortunate to have one old hard-headed German following another.